Hello friends, welcome to Odesh Academy. Friends, writing an essay is both an art as well as science. It is a science in a way because essay should follow a particular structure. It should reflect your knowledge. But at the same time, essay is also an art because you should express it beautifully. And secondly, that you should express it according to the requirement or aspiration of the reader or the examiner. Let us take any form of art. Suppose you are making a painting. When you are making a painting, the painting is not made only for yourself. You are making a painting so that people can appreciate it. A good painting is one which is appreciated by the people. In the same way, a good piece of music is one which is liked by the audience. A good movie is one which is appreciated by the audience. A good fiction is one which is appreciated by the readers. So a writer should, as an artist, should get into the skin of the person who is going to assess the essay. And he should know exactly for what purpose the essay is being written. For example, when you are writing an essay for civil services examination, it is not merely a test of your writing skill. It is not an essay competition where you are writing that you will be given marks based on the quality of your essay. The essay writing is part of the selection process for the civil servants. And certain qualities are to be checked when you are writing an essay. So friends, we should be very much clear as to what is the purpose of writing the essay, and we should accordingly write the essay so that we can get the maximum marks and we can get the best assessment for our essays. When you are writing an essay or any article or a blog, one purpose is that you express your true thoughts and feeling. But that is when you are not expecting any response from other people. Sometimes when you write an essay, you are doing exclusively for the audience. You want maximum number of views, maximum number of likes or upvotes on your essays, articles or writings. So what is there in your mind as to whether my essay is going to be liked by other people or not? So you write to please them. Sometimes you write an essay to impress the examiner with your writing skills and knowledge. So you write an essay in a very fantastic manner, with best use of the words, with no grammatical mistake, so that you can express the examiner with your writing skill. Sometimes you write to impress an expert or the critics who are expert in a particular field. But here, in civil service examination, you are writing an essay to impress the examiner who must find that you are a very suitable candidate for the civil services. So let us understand as to what is being tested in the civil services examination in the essay paper. The first important thing which is being tested is the knowledge. A civil servant should be a knowledgeable person. He should know what is happening all over the country and in fact all over the world and how it is going to impact the society. When he is posted in a particular department, he should have thorough knowledge of the subject, because often he is the final decision-making authority of that department. If he doesn't possess the knowledge, there is a high likelihood that other people will exploit him or he will end up issuing wrong order and taking wrong decisions. And therefore, knowledge is very, very essential for the civil servant. And how the knowledge should be acquired? It should be acquired from the reliable sources. Nowadays, people get impressed with the knowledge which is circulated in the social media and the WhatsApp, and without verifying the sources, they start believing that that is a correct knowledge, which is absolutely wrong. There is a very famous quote by George Bernard Shaw. He said, "Beware of the false knowledge. It is more dangerous than ignorance." A false knowledge is very dangerous because you consider that as a true knowledge and commit a great mistake. If you feel that you are ignorant, you will acquire knowledge and gradually you become knowledgeable. But once you have the false knowledge, you will be complacent and you will be doing a wrong thing and taking wrong decisions. A civil servant is a generalist person. He should know something of everything and everything of something. A civil servant should be able to speak and write on any topic. Essay is also one of the subjects where a variety of topics are there. Practically, you cannot predict as to which topic is covered in the civil services essay paper. Or I must say, which topic is not covered, because any question can be asked on that. But remember that your knowledge is going to be tested. So choose a topic where you know well, where you have the right knowledge. Remember that you should not write anything which is wrong. Don't make a guesswork, because if you write something wrong, immediately the examiner will be put off and a negative impression will be created and you will lose marks. You should not incorporate any data or quotation or a statement which is false or not from the right source. If you are having a shortage of material, then it is better that whatever you know, you elaborate rather than writing something which is false. The second important attribute which is tested in the civil services paper is the integrity. Integrity is the most important ingredient in the civil services. If the civil servant has all the qualities, extremely intelligent, hardworking, but if he is corrupt, he is misdirected, then he can do more danger to the country and the society than the benefits. And therefore, this is one of the very important things which is tested in the civil services paper. You will often find essays in the civil services paper which deals with morality, ethics. In the 2018 paper itself, there were at least three essays which were dealing exclusively with this issue. The essays were, customary morality cannot be a guide to a modern life. A people that values its privileges above its principle loses both. And reality does not conform to the ideal but confirms it. So friends, you can see that there are a lot of emphasis on integrity. So your essay writing should reflect your integrity. You should not be wavering that idealism doesn't matter or integrity is not possible, honesty is not possible. Your answer should be very much pertinent and it should point out that you are a man of integrity. The third important thing you should know is that a civil service has certain requirement from the candidate. A civil servant must have certain attributes. Now, what are those attributes? Integrity, impartiality, political neutrality, objectivity, dedication to public service, empathy, tolerance, and compassion toward the weaker sections. Now, these are the things which are expected from a civil servant. Now, whenever you are writing your essay, it is basically a subjective representation of your thought. And therefore, all these qualities must be reflected wherever it is required, whenever you are writing an essay. The fourth important thing which the essay would like to test is your loyalty toward the Constitution. A civil servant is a public servant. He is also taking the decisions, very, very important decision, on behalf of the government. And government is run by the Constitution of India. Therefore, a civil servant is expected to be loyal toward the values which are enshrined in the Constitution. So, the preamble of the Constitution has summarized the different type of values which should be there in the government officer. It says, "We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, liberty, equality, fraternity." Now please remember that these are the values which are the core values of our country. We are a socialist country, we are a secular country, we are a democratic country. And you should have justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity. So all these things has to be ingrained into you, because you are expected to become a civil servant. And therefore, your essay should reflect all these things in your essay. Now, for example, you should not take any stand which is not secular in nature. Even if you personally is not secular, still your essay should be secular in nature. Similarly, it should be democratic. Even though you may not be a fan of democracy, you may think other form of governments are better, But when you are writing an essay, make sure that it is in conformity with the democratic values which are enshrined in the Constitution. Clarity of thought. A civil servant should have a clarity of thought. A clear thinking leads to clear writing. If your thoughts are confused, your writing will also not be clear. A confused person's writing cannot be clear at all. And when a confused person is sitting on the chair of a civil servant, he cannot take decisions because he is not sure which path to follow, which way to go. And therefore, it is expected that you will take clear-cut stand on every issue. While writing an essay, you can discuss diverse point of view. All point of view can be presented during writing the essay. But finally, when you are concluding, it should be clear as to which side you stand. Your answer should provide the clear-cut solution of the problem which has been taken up during the essay. The sixth important thing is the writing skill. Writing skill is also something which is tested. Why? Because civil servants are not speakers. They are not like politicians who have to speak and get the attention of the people. They have to work mostly on file. They have to pass orders which can be challenged before different courts and tribunals. Their order has to be clear. They should be unambiguous. There should be no spelling or grammatical mistake in the order. And these things are also tested when you are writing an essay. So writing skill is very, very important. When you are writing something, one thought should flow naturally from the other. There should be a logical order. There should be an order in which the thoughts are presented so that the person who reads that essay should actually get the meaning and he find that your essay is interesting. And finally, the presentation of the essay. You may be writing a very good essay, but if it is not presented well, it may fail to create impression in the mind of the examiner. So your presentation is also equally important. Now, presentation means handwriting. You should have a good handwriting. At least your words should be all very legible, clear. The examiner should be able to read it very clearly. You can also use quotations. You can use anecdotes, data, figures, diagrams to make your essay more interesting, more presentable, so that the persons who are reading the essay can really enjoy it. Once they start, they cannot leave it. It should be in that way it has been presented. So friends, today we have learned as to what is the purpose of essay paper in the civil service examination. What are the qualities which are tested while you are writing your essay paper? And you should keep that in background of your mind while writing and practicing the civil services essay paper. Thank you very much for watching this lesson.